The Horns of Hashut care nothing for the secrets that the ravening ruin might contain. Their only desire is to burn and destroy everything in sight until nothing remains of the Gnarwood except ash and flames. In this video, we're going to show you how to paint a Ruinator Alpha to a battle-ready standard. Now, the first thing we need to do is undercoat the model, and to do this, we've used Chaos Black. After that, we'll begin our base coats using Corvus Black for the trousers and the boots, Galvorback Red for the red clothing, Morgas Bone for the cloth, and then finally Grey Sear for the smoke and the eyes. So let's take some Corvus Black onto the palette here. I'm going to thin it down with some water and roll my brush up to a nice point. Then we're going to apply that onto those trousers and boots of the model. Now we're going to pick out the red clothing using Galvorback Red. You might want to do a couple of thin coats for this. Next we're using Morgas Bone on the cream cloth. Again, you'll want to do a couple of thin coats of this. Now we're going to use Grey Sear on the smoke and the eyes. I'm using a small layer brush for this as it is finer detail. And with those first few details picked out, we can now move on to the next stages. So we're going to use Rakarth Flesh for the straps on the model, then Dark Reaper to pick out the blue areas, Rhinox Hide for the leather pouch, and then Nightquest or Flesh for the flesh. So let's start off with some Rakarth Flesh here. I'm going to put that on the palette, add a touch of water, and roll my brush up to a point. Then we're going to carefully pick out those straps. Be as neat as you can, but if you do make any mistakes, you can always just tidy back up. Now we're going to use Dark Reaper to pick out some of the blue details on the model. If you're not sure where these are, you can just refer back to the box art. Next we're using Rhinox Hide to pick out that leather pouch. With the pouch done, we're now going to use Nightquest or Flesh to pick out all of the flesh areas. This will need a couple of thin coats. And with that done, we can now move on to our metallics. So for the silver, we're using Iron Hand Steel. Then for the copper, we're using Hashut Copper. So let's take some Iron Hand Steel onto the palette here and just add a touch of water to thin it down slightly. Then roll my brush up to a point, and we're going to be applying that onto all of the silver areas of the model. Next, we're going to pick out the copper areas using Hashut Copper. If you're not sure where these are, just refer back to the box art. And with all those base coats done, we can move on to our contrasts and shades. So we're going to start off with Basilicanum Grey, then Dark Oath Flesh and Skeleton Horde. These will all be thinned down with contrast medium. Then we'll be using Reichlin Flesh Shade on the copper areas and Karandras Green for the smoke and the eyes. So we're going to take two parts contrast medium here on the palette. Quick rinse on my brush there, make sure to dry it off. Then one part Basilicanum Grey and mix that together there. Once that's mixed, we're going to be applying that onto the silver areas of the model. We're also going to pick out the blue areas, the red areas, and also that leather pouch on the back. Next, we've mixed one part contrast medium to one part Dark Oath Flesh, and we're going to apply this all over the flesh. Next, we've thinned down Skeleton Horde with one part contrast medium, and we're applying this onto the cloth and the straps. Next, we're applying Reichlin Flesh Shade all over those copper areas. Next, we're using Karandras Green on that smoke and eyes. And with that all done, we can now move on to basing the miniature. So for this, we're going to use Sterling Mud, then apply a coat of Wild Wood over the top. So let's get some Sterling Mud using our texture tool. We're going to use the large side, and we're going to apply that carefully onto the base of the miniature. Around the feet, I'm going to switch to the smaller end of the texture tool just to help me carefully move it around the model's feet. After leaving that for about an hour to dry, we're going to apply a coat of wildwood over the top. This is just to help darken those recesses. The final thing to do is to paint the rim of the base in a colour that matches the rest of your warband. In this case, we've used Abaddon Black. And now our Ruinator Alpha is ready to charge into the Gnarlwood, shattering bones and inspiring fear into all who cross their path. So, just a couple of things to remember. When you're base coating, be as neat as you can, as this will provide a better end result. However, if you do make any mistakes, you can always just tidy up after. Also, when you're using metallics, it's a good idea to change your water, as this will avoid any metallic flakes getting into your non-metallic paints. Well, that's the end of the video. We hope you've enjoyed watching, and we hope you have great fun painting your own miniatures. We'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye!